This morning on The Dish, rising star chef, author, and teacher Samin Nosrat. Born in San Diego, she loved her mother's traditional Iranian cooking, but her inspiration to make food her career came during college after dining at Berkeley's legendary Chez Panisse. She started working there and impressed acclaimed chef Alice Waters, who's called her America's next great cooking teacher.
That's pretty impressive. And that prediction certainly seems to be coming true. Last year, her first cookbook, Salt, Fat, Acid, Heat, became a bestseller, won a James Beard Award, and inspired a new Netflix series by the same name. In the series, the Salt segment was filmed in Japan. Here's a clip.
It tastes very minerally. Like, I can taste rocks almost. Do you want some?
No.
Samin Nosrat, welcome to The Dish.
Thank you so much for having me.
Tell us what's on this great table.
So I'll start with the buttermilk marinated chicken, which is just so beautiful and gets so golden brown. This is a classic Persian rice called tadi. Gets the crispy rice from the bottom of the pan. This is a Brussels sprouts and butternut squash agrodolce, like a sweet and sour and spicy thing. That's a beautiful salad that I love to make in the fall with persimmons and chicories and pomegranates and walnuts, nice and acidic and bright. And this is my friend Lori's classic midnight chocolate cake.
It's just sort of and this?
Oh, this is the what I call the Caruso after my friend Greta Caruso. It's her classic drink.
Greta has a drink.
Thank you, Greta, because I just had a sip of it.
Totally. I'm going to have it's grapefruit juice and lots of lime.
Delicious.
Cheers.
Cheers. Yes.
Congratulations on your James Beard Award. Thank you for being here.
Salt, fat, acid, heat. You've called these the holy grail of elements, but explain what that means, actually.
So the idea is I sort of realized that everything around the world, all good cooking, is united by these four basic elements. And if we can learn how to use them and how to balance them, when to add them, and in what form, we can make anything taste good.
That simple.
I'm sorry.
That is what we love to see.
When you were attracted to Chez Panisse, in college, I mean, how do you go from the front to the back?
Yeah, I didn't know anything. You know, I grew up eating great home cooking, and so I didn't really know anything about fancy restaurants, but my college boyfriend always wanted to eat there. So we saved up $220 over the course of 7 months.
Insane.
Wow.
And we went to have dinner there. That really changed my life, to eat in this beautiful restaurant, to be so taken care of.
You call it a temple of sensory delight.
It is a temple of sensory delight.
Yeah.
And so I just was so moved that I wrote a letter to the owner, to Alice Waters, and asked her for a job bussing tables.
What?
And then within a few weeks, I was so enchanted by the temple of sensory delights that I begged them to teach me how to cook.
This is interesting to me. You've said that you became a writer and a chef because you felt like an outsider.
Oh, right? Absolutely. I have always felt, I grew up in San Diego. I was definitely different coming from an Iranian family with a different name. And all of my sort of differences, I think, have brought me into a career where I really just want to include people. And by telling stories, and both food and words are ways for me to do that and bring people in.
Mm-hmm. In the Netflix show and having watched parts of some of them, that's exactly what you do. But why do a show like this versus, the cookbook seems like, okay, I get it, but why do a show like this?
To me, I felt so lucky to have the opportunity to do the show. And again, to me, there's kind of a beautiful analogy between the idea that these four elements appear in cuisines all around the world and show us that good food everywhere is more similar than it is different. And I think the same thing is true for humans. You know, we are more similar than we are different. So getting to meet people and share their stories and show that is all I ever really want to do.
Was it the wabi-sabi, the imperfection? Yeah. I love that. We'll have you sign the dish.
Oh, thank you so much.
As we do. If you could have this meal with anyone, past or present, who would it be?
I would have to say Michelle Obama, my hero.
Oh. Yeah. We got to make that one happen.
Yeah.
I don't know if we can. Someone
watching. She's watching.
That's right. Chef Samin Nosrat, thank you so
much. Thank you so much for having me.
And for more on Samin and The Dish, you can head to our website at cbsthismorning.com.